Yeah, okay, we're going. All right, so now, let's go ahead and get into the programming stuff. Okay, so let's see, I gotta try and pick up where we were from last time and figure out what I've done and what I did that was incorrect or was correct. So we started doing the window cost stuff apparently. I think we went through and did all the if statements. Let me check all that stuff out. Do a sanity check on myself here, make sure I didn't do anything stupid. So first, let's take a look at this. So we got these up. Pass fail, blah, 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 blah. Pass fail, list color, enable gold. So enable gold cost, enable item cost. Alright. Gold cost formula, update item, and then the item cost formula. Then we have the cost mode enabled. Equals this true or this true. And then we're doing our if statements off of this. So, pass this part, and this part we don't need right now. Alright, so if be cost mode enabled, create cost window. Okay, I think we did all this and we checked it and it was working properly, and then we were getting into the actual creating of the window itself, which I think actually did work. And or did it. Let me run this real fast and we'll see what happens, and then I'll get a better idea of exactly where we were. So if this loads up and there's a window that shows up for the cost, and then I'll know that that's where we're at. Crap, it's gonna be loud, I think. I guess not. Never mind. I'll leave it there. Normally I put it on 16, but leave it at 8 for now. Alright. Oh, that's right, we had a type error. Or no, what's the type error about? Probably about the code we're writing right now. 298. Oh yeah, it's about the code. I saw it earlier and then I'd forgotten about it. We need to do dot prototype at the end of that. Alright, now if we load this, it should at least load because we're not doing anything after this that's doing any of this stuff, so. And there's no. Or wait, no, yes. Scene class. Scene class change not defined on 308. Oh. What the heck? Oh, correct cost window, that's fine. Okay. I was like, that shouldn't be there. And I was like, oh, okay, that's one of the new things. And then we got prototype of undefined. Down here, probably that type of window selectable or something. Window selectable. Oh, hell. Host. So, const. And 1129. And it's not dots underscore. Okay, now. We fixed all my brain melting issues from before. Oh, from yesterday, hopefully. And it should at least load this part. I don't know if it'll actually work or not. We'll see. Okay, so get height. Cannot read because undefined. 1312. So somewhere we have a function, or rather, we're calling a function from another window that doesn't exist yet. 312. 312 is so statwind, recwind, comwind. All dot get height, so that doesn't really help. It's probably comwind, to be honest. Well, it says get height of undefined. Cannot read property type of. Okay, Because we are creating the window before the other windows have been created. So those are null. So we need to call it after we create the com window. So technically... So it would have been both the rec and the com window, but it would have been, it's the rec window that was storing it because it's the newest one. Or not newest, it's the one that happened. It's the one that is called before com, but com would have also thrown it. Alright. Now we got another problem, still undefined on 312. Okay, now what? So, stat window, rec window, com window. Get height of undefined. Something's still not defined. So, command window, cost window. It's com window and rec window. This underscore com wind, rec wind, and stat wind, which should be a capital W. Okay, so every one of those calls to get night would have failed because they wouldn't have existed. Or rather, not have been initialized. Either that or it would have returned incorrect values. So now, let's see what else happens. Okay, we got some other issue here. Yet again, 312. What is with this damn thing? Jeez. Get height plus this rec window, get height plus this com window, get height. You know what? Alright, sources, let's just do this, because it'll be easier to figure it out. I'm pretty sure one of them doesn't have it, though. Troll find. So, window cc command prototype.get. Yeah, so window width. So we don't actually have it here. That's probably why. So, and we're not even saving them either, so this underscore when h equals h. I don't even know why we have to put these here, because they don't actually mean anything at the end of these JavaScript functions. It's just a force of habit or something, I guess, that people have gotten into. So they don't throw errors when you don't have them. It doesn't cause things not to work. It's just style, I guess. I mean, if you're doing a call from within the parameter list of another function, then yes, you have to put it there, because it, like, locks off the end of the thing, but you don't need it with this function definitions like this, but people do this anyway, so I will continue to do it, even though it makes no sense. Because I've already, you know what? Let's just do this. Hopefully this doesn't cause any issues. I don't think there's any place where I'm using them actually legitimately. Actually, there are some places. These are indented in extra space. Oh, wow. Wait. There. Okay, never mind. Those were properly, correctly indented. Okay, there we go. Everything else just was not properly indented. Alright. Whoops. A few too many. Got a little too backspace happy there. Alright, let's get rid of all this extra space we don't even need. It's just hanging around here for some reason. Okay. So now, I don't really think there's any reason why I would need to have... I don't think there's anything where I'm using it in here where... Well, yeah, no, because it's off of this, so... Should be fine if I just say... Oh, well. What the heck? Find... Curly brace. Closing curly brace. That. Replace with just this. Okay, I guess there were some places where it was being used correctly. So find anywhere where we have two of them together. I'll have to fix these two. Okay, so now that should be fine. So get height we just did. I'll see if there's anything else. No issues with it, so I think that's going to be fine. Alright, get height, send a... Jesus. 309. So it's still... God. This thing's kicking my arse. Okay, what is wrong with you? Speak. Alright, let's go ahead and do what I was going to do, which is to pull this over here and pull this out. So then go to the debug window here, 309. So I gotta figure out what's actually happening here. Alright, refresh. Alright, so what the hell is going on? What the hell indeed? Okay, here we go. So, Comwind has... is defined, okay. We have a height. Requind. Really? Requind is undefined. Why is requirements window undefined? Oh god, it's a Q, not a C. How did I not see that? No pun intended. Actually, no, pun entirely intended. Oh, well, I fixed some other things and, fixed some weird standard things that people do, and now we have... Okay, that's just normal. That's a normal error for the normal thing that was not named correctly. Alright. Get rid of that, because I don't need it anymore. Activate not found. For property on line what? 13311, yes. Okay. Cost window. Because why? Because we did this before instead of after. When it should be done after, not before. The creation of the window. So that we can then add the window. This dot add window. This_cost_wind. Wow. Okay. Let's this be a lesson. Never code when your brain is melting. Now what? So when X, because X is supposed to be capital. What's that, 4, 3, 11? X and Y. I just find it easier to find all the problems this way because you look through it. Unless you're like paying extreme attention to every character, you'll miss stuff. Like I'm missing stuff just by looking at it and not recognizing that was lowercase instead of uppercase. Just faster for me that way. Okay, there we go. So the window is not showing right now because probably because the cost is disabled. I'm hoping. So one is enabled, one is, well no, because it wouldn't be going down there if it wasn't enabled, so it's true. So this cost window. So it could be behind another window because it's not being displayed correctly, I suppose. So width, let's see, no, we're looking for the, switches around. Just, it's a matter of, what the hell. No, stop hitting page up. Alright, so 1x is the width of class list window, which is fine, that means move it this way. When y should be the height of the stat window, which it is. Win width of the stat window, which it is. And then the win height, which is the graphics box height minus the stat window. Well, no, I did this because we want to get what's left on that chunk. And if we add up what's here minus the total box height, we should get what's there. So that should be fine. So, then we're passing that through to the constructor, just down here. So selectable, struct, object crates, create constructor, initialize call this, XY. Of course, this is fine. You have to pass through the actual variables to get them to actually be used. Derp. Alright. Now, it should be there. And we'll see if it's actually correctly created. Actually, it won't show until we go to... until we go select a class to show the cost. Anyway, so... Alright, so it's not showing it. We have no problems over here. So let's go ahead and check out what it's actually passing through to the constructor for the size values. Okay, all the way to the bottom. Okay, let's put a breakpoint there. Okay. So we want to say what the X is, 200, okay. Y is that, okay. Width is 400 and height is 0. Oh, what is 0? Well, there's a problem there. We have a height of 0. So let's go back up to the scene, which is 211. Put a break after that. Go back. Alright, so, plus when height, which is 0. Alright, so let's see what, so graphics dot box height is 642.24. So we want the height of, then we want this. Actually equals it shouldn't. Because there's a space there that's not being used. It must equal to, it must equal that because that's what it's coming out as. But why? It shouldn't. The height of the stat window is not that big. Okay, well, screw it then. We'll just have to do this by, maybe it's because of the way that we're actually populating those values. Because how it should really go now is on the if statement. Okay, we passed the period. So, rec window, requirements window. The requirements window X. No, the width. Oh, we do that. Okay, never mind. X, H. So where it's placed on X is by class window. That's X, Y is what we're talking about here. So if it's enabled, then it should be the Y, which it is, X class window. Like get height. Window height is class window minus box height times 75. So should be of course, this is going to fail on our check because we're creating it after all this is already created. So we have to figure out a different way to do the height on here then, which is fine. So let's see. What we could do then is just do, instead of doing this, let's get the stat one then. Stat one there, something like that. We could say stat one height minus this underscore act classes window dot get height. I think we have that for that. Find window actor. Yeah, we do. Okay. So then if we say, all right, so the height will be the space in between where stat window stops and where class window stops, actor class window, so the space in between the two. Hopefully that'll work this way. Then we can, instead of doing all that weird stuff down here, we just base off the class window for this. And then for the command window, it doesn't matter because it'll be still be whatever for the still be based off of whatever the requirements are. I decided to do that first. We don't actually need it, so. And it's actually the exact same thing, I'm pretty sure. Anyway, so. Alright, let's see what this does. So first, we gotta deal with any, I expect a token 433. Seriously, yeah, because I didn't define it for, did not define it for, of course. I knew that, and I realized that, but didn't click for some reason. So this underscore, width equal, am I doing it that way, or am I doing it win height? You know, win WH or whatever. I'm doing it win H, win W. Alright. Let's make sure we keep it the same then. Consistent. Win height. Don't know if we'll need the width actually or not, but in case we do, it's there. Window cost dot prototype dot get height function. Return this to underscore win height. Alright, that should deal with that. Ah, there's a missing C. Need one more C. Okay. And cannot see, I've undefined, height of undefined. Get height 443, because now at this point it's not defined. Damn. Okay. Back down to here. So we're going based off actor class wind. That's done. Now we passed it. Now where are you? Back there where you were. Okay. Had to undo the redo of the undo of the mistake. Okay. So, so stat wind height. So our current height is -123 because stat wind. Oh. We should have it the other way. Stat wind's always going to be smaller than that. But 123 is our window size. And I tried to save within that. I don't think that works. Or I don't know, it could, maybe.